Turn your light on.
Hey, it's me, Destin. Quick video. So, we're in the middle of nowhere. You probably hear the bugs. Having to light myself with a little handheld flashlight here. Trent, what up?
What up?
Trent's on his kayak, I'm on this kayak. We are in a pond, and there's milfoil all around us. Dude, is that... That's the furnace from the foundry. They're making steel over there. That's rad. Also, near that is like the biggest rocket plant in the world. But anyway, we're in a really cool location is the point. It's very peaceful. You can hear the bugs. But check this out. There's milfoil all around us, right? I'm in a kayak. Check what happens if you stick this light in the water. Now, my eyes can see this a lot better than you can. But I can see just all kinds of vegetation underwater. Okay, you ready to show them?
Oh yeah.
Get your flashlight, go to the other side. So we figured this out. Put your light in the water, and you can see the beam, right? Now stick your arm further down underwater and aim up, and it bounces off the top of the water. How cool is that? Hold on, let me zoom in. Can't focus for nothing, man. Do it again. Neat. Okay, now if you go too far, it'll break through. That's cool. There's a thing called Snells Window. Do you know about Snells Window? If you're scuba diving, for example, and you're in the water, and you look up, you can see the sun, but you can only see it at a certain angle. So there's this window right above you where you can see the light coming through, but beyond that, the light reflects out. And so what Trent's doing over there has to do with the index of refraction of water. Is that right? Index of refraction? Oh, I don't know. I don't know the big words. I just know I'm on a kayak. I hear the bugs. And it's awesome. Okay. I'm going to come up to you and try to get this angle.
Dude, look at all the stuff on top of the water.
I see that, yeah. All right. You're going to have to help steer, man.
Cool. Hold on.
All right, bounce it at me again.
You see it?
Yeah. Why is that so neat?
I don't know.
Can I try it?
Moving with the, yeah.
Here, trade lights with me. Here, here's the camera.
Okay.
What a neat... Dang, you just figured that out, huh?
Yeah, I was just playing. Oh, dude, that looks great from over here.
Isn't that neat? And then it should just bust through. Look at that. You can see the beam goes...
Dude, it bends more when the...
Did you see what happens, though? Like, half the beam punches through the water, half the beam doesn't. Watch. So the beam in the water goes dark. So coming up, 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 then it starts to go dark. And then the whole thing punches through.
Wow.
Do you see what's happening? Because it has a an angular pattern or distribution with the light itself. Half of it is busting through and half of it's not. I wonder if that means... Yes. You see it?
Dude, that is awesome.
You're smart, man. That was a really good find. How gnarly is that?
Dude, that looks incredible from over here. Like, it bends, man. Like, it... Maybe bend isn't the right word. It bounces. It, like, literally... Gah.
There's this moment where...
All right, we got to get closer again.
Yep. Here we go. Yep. Tilt it up. It's this moment it punches through.
Oh, wow.
So cool is you've got all that particulate matter in the water so you can see the beam. Oh man, we gotta do this with a laser. We have to do this with a laser. You don't have a laser on your gun, do you?
No, I don't. It would be in the water if it did.
Yeah. Did you see?
see that bug? There was a bug swimming around in the water, and he just got to the surface and just started flying.
Are you serious?
Yes. He's like, I just do whatever I want. It's like, I don't follow the rules.
Hold on, let me try to focus on the light beam. I can.
A what?
I can focus on the crap in the water.
That's it. I hope you enjoyed doing science on a kayak with us. That's it. I feel like we could sneak up on aminals.
I'll go find that beaver.
Do you want to go sneak up on a beaver?